Okay, well, how about hymn number 86, How Great Thou Art? They're ready, so.
Time during when the Pharisees lived, for them, because, you know, even in today's Middle Eastern countries, there are two types of rabbinical thoughts. And the one is where you cannot divorce your wife for any reason unless it is adultery. And the second is you can divorce your wife even if you do not like the food she cooks. And you can just go to the court of law and you can apply for a divorce and you can get divorced. So these two rabbinical thoughts came to Jesus and wanted to ask him what was his opinion. Look at the next verse, what it says. Verse 4, and he answered and said to them, have you not read that he who made them at the beginning made them male and female? From where is Jesus quoting? Anybody can tell me? Right, Genesis chapter 1. Keep your finger here and let's go to Genesis chapter 1, verse 27. Can anybody read to me Genesis chapter 1, verse 27? Anybody with a loud voice? Or anybody who's ready?
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them.
Thank you, sister. But can you do me one favor? Can you read it again for me? Oh. And listen to this once again. The way it is written. Yes.
So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them.
Do normal people talk like this? In the image of God, you know, when you see the whole creation account, it's so simple. The first day, second day, this, that, you know, everything. But when you come to this particular verse, Genesis chapter verse 1, you're all like, you get confused. What is this? This kind of verse is called, in theology language, it's called paradigmatic parallelism. In other words, it's Hebrew poetry. When God came to the creation of man, he used poetry. How many men have written poems for their wives? Here. No one? Yeah? What degree of love were you in when you wrote that poem, right? You know, you write poems because you are in love. The creation of human was so emotional for God that when it came to tell Moses, he said it in a poetic language. And we wonder, how much does God love us? Even the disciples, if you go to the verse 12, if you go to the verse 10, his disciples said to him, if such is the case of the man with his wife, it is better not to marry. Right? Even the disciples were so afraid of the concept of coming in to somebody. They did not want to fall in love. But when God made man or human, he wanted to get into it, into a relationship. He was ready to commit anything, even for a sin problem. This right here is ultimate love. You won't find anywhere in the world. Don't take it lightly just because it's not, the symbol of blood and flesh of your loved one. It is of your loved one who died 2,000 years ago from you. And so when you take part of this, I request you to consecrate your life. Tell Jesus everything because he loves you. He's so emotional that he writes a poem for you. He wants to know everything about you. He wants to be in your life. As we break the bread and as we take this wine, may we remember and may we ponder upon this thought today. I invite the elders to please break the bread. Thank you.
hands as we say a prayer over the bread. Dear Father, we thank you that you are the bread of life. You are that life-giving spirit who has brought sustenance and power to this dying world. We thank you for your light. We thank you for your truth. We thank you for sacrificing everything so that we who have caused you so much pain can be forgiven and brought back into your fold. Bless this bread as we take it in remembrance.
I'm giving you my life.
live like me. You get to share my character. You get to share what I've seen. You get to open your eyes of understanding and understand something which many don't get it. You get to understand Jesus. As you live a life victorious, as you live a life away from sin, remember, God has given you an intellectual that many do not have. He has given you the privilege of understanding Him. As we take this wine, may we remember we are privileged above everyone. We are nobodies in this world. We are precious in His eyes. Though it may sound very superficial to you in the struggles of life, but remember that you are in the struggles of life because you are special. You would not be in this situation if you were a simple, common person. But you are special. And that's why special people get to go through the furnace of fire. And in that furnace, the world will say, I see someone like the Son of God. Same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, your Son was pierced for our rebellion, crushed for our sins. He was beaten so we could be whole. He was whipped so we could be healed. All of us like sheep have strayed away, but it is Christ's blood that cleans us whiter than snow. Lord, we ask that you bless this grape juice and that this may be a moment when our hearts may be cleansed whiter than snow. Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
This is what Jesus got. We got the fresh grape juice, full to the cup. The privilege, the mercy. And this is what Jesus got. And he accepted it on heaven's cost. I always want you to remember, whenever you take part in communion, that he gave you the privilege of getting the fresh grape juice. I like how Sister White puts it. After the communion service, our faces should not be as if we've gone to a funeral. We should be victorious.
Amen.
There is victory.
Amen.
You know, when I look at the different religions and different gods, nobody rose like Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus rose. You can find everybody's shrine and tomb, but the tomb is empty.
Amen.
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 And Jesus is in heaven for us.
Amen.
That we may declare that God is glorious. That my God lives. That my God is with me. That he can listen to me. That in life's trials, while I have the fresh grape juice, he accepted the cup.
Amen.
May God bless you. As we close, let us all join our voices and sing hymn number 337, Redeemed by His Infinite Mercy. Father, you are our creator. You are our redeemer. You are our sustainer, O Lord. Help us to be like you. And wherever we roam, wherever we are standing, may there be hope shining through our face because we believe in Jesus. As we dismiss from here, O Lord, send us with hope and mercy. Send us with the promise of your word. Because even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil,
Amen.
For you are with me.
Amen.
Help us to remember that. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Let all God's people say, Amen.
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 Thank you so much, everybody, for taking part in this communion service. May this experience go with you, and may it strengthen you for the rest of the week.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.